Oh man, the list of those substances is bigger and bigger every day which are prohibited. And now let's talk about a bit of Osterin cheaters. And about Osterin, I'll just tell you that this is also known as MK2866. It's a SARM, Selective Androgen Receptor Module, which is created by GTX to avoid and treat muscle wasting. It can later on be a cure for avoiding atrophy, total wasting away of body part, cachexia, sarcopenia, and hormone or testosterone replacement therapy. This type of SARM, well, cannot only retain lean body mass, but as well as increase it. It's often mistaken as S1, but S1 was created earlier, is no longer going through the expansion. Here are the benefits, the basic benefits the fighters should know. Increased lean mass gains, better strength, more endurance, joint healing abilities, anabolic even at doses as low as 3 milligrams. And this is what I want to say, fighters are looking for a very, very famous ways to cheat, and Osterin has again popped up as the culprit in the contaminated supplement case involving UFC fighters, and 4 Osterin cheaters accepted 6-month suspensions, per the promotion's anti-doping administrator. The USADA announced settlements after out-of-competition test failures from Augusto Mendes, Marvin Vettori, Sean O'Malley, and the inaugural flyweight champ Nico Montano. Well, this is not good. Augusto Mendes, March 7th, 2018. Marvin Vettori, August 24th, 2018. Sean O'Malley, September 5th and December 8th, 2018. And Nico Montano, October 25th, 2018, and all but one Nico Montano, they are allowable to compete within their 6 months terms, which goes retroactively to the date of the provisional suspensions. O'Malley and Vettori, well, they kind of shared reactions on social media. They aimed at all people that talked shit in the past year, right? Osterin. Well, I don't know about Osterin, but welterweight team means his long time teammate of Montano. He accepted a 6-month term after linking to a failed test. Heavyweight Josh Barnett, Josh Fartnett, he was able to avoid the penalty when he documented the use in USADA. It explained the delay in announcing the settlements as a consequence of the long results management process in tainted supplement cases. Well, USADA announced a group of settlements following the discovery of tainted supplements 1 year ago. The anti-doping agency, as well as you remember, it cut a deal with 3 Brazilian fighters after they took supplements from compounding pharmacies that allegedly sold products tainted with PEDs. Junior Dos Santos, well, he was critical of the third-party firm for delaying his career. USADA no longer announces potential anti-doping violations, instead waiting for cases to be resolved. For example, in Mendes' case, news of his positive was publicly revealed because the anti-doping agency's news policy hadn't taken effect, and in the case of Vettori and O'Malley, both fighters announced they'd failed the USADA test and vowed to contest the results. O'Malley, well, Sean O'Malley is a weed lover too, his pair of test failures was treated as a single violation because the amount of Osterin in both samples was consistent with the ingestion prior to the first positive. Well, you can kind of read here about Osterin and what USADA announced today. I hope you will all enjoy reading, and I will also film another video on it of Nico Montano. Well, she kind of tested an out-of-competition test, accepted 6-month period in liability that began on November 15, 2018, the date she was provisionally suspended from competition. USADA conducts the year-round independent anti-doping program for all UFC athletes. Now, I don't know, man, this is turning into a freak show. I mean, there are cheaters on every single step, but this Come on, man, every single fighter is cheating. What the heck is going on? This is terrible.